Excellent, a very high primary stability. You wanted to know more about the surface treatment. It's sandblasting. It means there are some projection of a small titanium balls on the surface of the implant that will create some micro holes on the surface, and like this the bone will go into these tiny holes for a better osseo integration of the implant. So it's sandblasting with titanium balls and acid etching with nitric and fluoridric acid. It means after the projection of these small balls of titanium on the surface of the implant will be put in a bath of acids, and the acids, they will also remove some tiny pieces of implants, and it will create rugosity, roughness on the surface of the implant to have a good osseo integration. So sandblasting and acid etching. It's like a Straumann implant, it's like most of the implants today, the most common used surface treatment. And this surface treatment increases the bone implant contact of 70%. So it means if you have an implant that is smooth with no surface treatment, it has 70% less contact with the bone. So it's really a necessary surface treatment that we do in the company. Is it clear?
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay.
So for the kit, the surgical kit, for all the kits, we have different protocols according to bone density. Because if you have a very soft bone or a very hard bone, you will not do you will not pass the same drills. When the bone is soft, you will pass less drills to have a reduced implant site so that the implant is really compressed in the bone. But if you have a hard bone, you don't want to compress too much the implant in the bone, so we will enlarge more the implant site, we will pass more drills to avoid the implant to be compressed. The protocol is always indicated in the kit. All the kits that we are going to see together. The indication of the protocol to follow is indicated on the kit, so you can look on the kit. Maybe with the light it will be better. Turn off the light. Yeah, but we can see like this. For example, so the indication, you have it here. Here it's the protocol, the step to follow in using the drills. For example, today during the workshop we are going to place implant diameter 4 mm, length 10. These jaws, it's a medium bone, like D2, D3 densities, so the protocol to follow will be this one. You can see implant diameter 4, D2, D3 densities. The protocol is from step 1 to step 4, and this plus 5, it means the drill number 5, you will pass it according to the bone density, according to how you feel the bone. If it's really it's a harder bone, you can pass the drill number 5, but it's more a soft bone, you don't pass it. So first, when in a real situation, you do the incision of the gingiva. Then you mark the bone with step 1. You can see on the kit, step 1, it's the point drill. You have two different point drills. The regular one, which has only this point of 5 mm, it's really just to mark the bone. Or you have this drill, which is very sharply, specifically to work in a post-extraction site, like this. So if you want to place an implant, after a tooth was extracted, you do not do your drilling here. You will always try to have bone here. So usually it's in palatal side. Here, more or less in the middle of the alveolus. So if you want to practice in the model with the tooth missing, you will do your drilling in palatal way at this level with a sharp first drill. So this first drill, On the kit, you can see number one. It's one of these two drills. Then number two, it should be number two, it is the drill of the length of the implant. In this case, it would be a 10 millimeter long implant. So you will choose the drill when it's indicated length 10. Then you can check your drilling size with the gauge that is in the kit with this part of the gauge. Then you go on, we will enlarge the drilling site according to the bone density. So you have a series of intermediate drills. They are indicated on the kit. In this case, to place an implant 4 millimeter of diameter, it's step 1 until 4. So step 1, point drill. Step 2, the drill. Step 1, the point drill, the one very sharpie or the classic one. Step 2, you choose the drill according to the length of the implant, you can see length 10. Then step 3, it is an intermediate drill. It is not with this drill, you can place all the lengths of implant. So for length 10, it will be first, second line, because the first one is for implant length 8, and the second one length 10. So the third drill. Then number 4, it's the same, it's just a bigger drill. First line 8, second line 10. So you will go down until the second line. Then we stop here. You can try to place your implant. If it goes down, okay. If maybe it does not fully go down, you can pass one more drill, the drill number 5 that we can see in the protocol. Drill number 5, depending on if you can place your implant or not. Here you have long drill. Just next to this long drill, you have the same drill, same diameter, it's just shorter. Short for when you will work maybe in posterior region, when your patient cannot open the mouth a lot. So this is why you have a short version. And the long version, especially if you work between the two incisors, that may be not to be bothered by the next, by the teeth next. So you will use a longer drill. And here on this line, you always have a depth gauge. So if you want to check the depth, your drilling depth, you want to see it's the right depth, you can check the first is 8, second 10. And then to place your implant, with the mandrel, you have the instrument to place the implant here on your left. So you can place the implant with the contra-angle, with the handpiece, with the mandrel. You go directly to pick up the implant in the connection. Or you can also place it manually. But manually, we do not recommend to place the implant fully manually, because you do not know the torque that is applied. Or you can use a dynamometric key that would indicate the torque of the insertion torque. It's very important to place the implant at the recommended torque. From 35 Newton, you have a good insertion torque, and you can even do immediate loading of the implant if you want, because it means that the implant has a good primary stability. Under 30 Newton, the implant doesn't have a very good primary stability. From this stability, it will depend, for example, if you want to do a one-time surgery or a two-time surgeries. If the implant is stable, you can do just a one-time surgery, put a healing abutment, and wait for the healing of the bone. If you place your implant at a torque inferior to 30 Newton, 20 Newton, it's better to put a cover screw to close your site and to wait for the implant to get osseointegrated, but without being touched, let's say, by the mouth. I don't know if it is clear. So the insertion torque of the implant is really important and must be respected. Also, when you use the drills, we recommend different speed for the motor. The first and second drill, it's 12,000. The motors, they are already set, at the required speed. To change the different speeds, you just have to press OK, and it will go to the set speed. So first and second step 12,000, and then for intermediate drills, we recommend to slow down a little bit to 800 rounds per minute. So usually the small drills, they go very fast, 12,000, and the bigger the drill is, and the lower we need to go for the speed of the drills. And the implant placement needs to be done very slowly, 15-20 rounds per minute, really to control the go down of your implant. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah? So you can choose either this mandible to place your implant, or this one, even if some have been used, you can use the alveolis. It's really more complicated. I don't know if you practice immediate placement of implant after extraction. So for those who are used to it, it will be easy. And for the others, I can recommend to use this mandible. You can place one, two, or three or more implants. We have lots if you want to practice. And after, we'll show you we have some models for immediate loading. But we don't have the models to do it today. So normally with this implant, you can place four natural teeth. Then we can screw the ball abutments in it. And we can fix the prosthesis, putting some rings in it. And you can come and clip the prosthesis directly on the implants. But it's the second step. The first step, you do your implant placement. And this is it, you can go.
So isn't she already ready?